Well, happy Saturday, Josh Who TV followers. It's Prime Country Saturday. Hope you're enjoying your free XM trial if you're in North America. Sign up for it. I really enjoy XM Radio. Here's the big-ass JC. This boat is just humongous. 2.5 biminis. We have a little cheater here in the middle, just because that's 5 feet between. And it's just too much for one piece. Massive, massive JC Tritoon. 350 Chevy in it. It scoots through the water rather well for its size. But because the lake is closed with the coronavirus and all that, and the state park is closed, so Lake Mead is closed. How's that for fun? This guy's not in a hurry. He's a really nice guy anyway. And he's not in a hurry for his boat. Nobody is, really. So we have this little one. Isn't this a beauty? I think he said it's a 52 Chris Craft. 1952 Chris Craft. And it's got a straight six in it. He fired it up the other day. Sounds neat. Beautiful little boat. And he needs a cover that's going to be about 4 inches above the white line is where we decided that it's going to land. And in order to fit it when it's in the water, we had to remove the landing gear so that I could get the cover to fit snug around there. But it's just a cool little boat. Very vintage. This is the throttle. Vintage gauges. And he just had the upholstery done, so it's time to make it a cover, and that's what we've got going on. It kind of took cuts in line. So the first step for me to make the cover for it was to use the pins and straps and get the vents down the middle of the boat. And finding something to anchor to so that I could pull the cover back and forth and move it all around. And these don't move. They stay put in place, centered in the middle of the boat. So I was just coming over here to pull these off because they're going onto the cover. So I actually need the vents. And then we'll get the cover done. Let's go over and take a look at the cover. Here is his cover, and we were just doing the marking where the reinforcements need to be and cutting the holes for the vent. And then over there I have the reinforcements for the vent, and now like where it's going to touch the back seat and a couple other, there's some cleats and whatnot that we're going to protect the cover from, top of the windshield as usual. But I wanted to catch it before I got too much farther. I want to thank you for following along. Well, good morning, Josh TV followers. There is the cover for the Chris Craft. Again, that's I believe it's a 1952 Chris Craft. Some kind of sport runabout. We've done the typical 2-inch double under hem that we do on all our covers. And then for this boat, I've put a little vinyl on the back side of the grommet so that if he ties a rope or he has a hook from a bungee cord, it's not going to be slapping up against the boat. So all the grommets have a backer. Going down the sides, they're 14 on center. Across the back, I just took that 14-inch and kind of centered it in the half. So again, he doesn't have to use all the tie-downs. But if one gets torn out, he has a sister right next to it that he can use. Nice soft reinforcement over the top of the windshield. Zippers for a cleat. The nose gear. Another cleat that will be added. So we're going to call this one done. Have him come get it Monday. Thanks so much for following along. All right. Hey there, Josh UTV followers. It is time to wind up Saturday. And we finished off this beautiful Chris Craft cover. Quite happy with that. There's one little spot I might touch up on it over on the other side, but I can do that Monday morning before he shows up. It's just a stitch I didn't like, so I think I might stitch over it just to make sure he's a happy camper and I don't see this cover again. And then we shifted our attention to the massive JC. I'm going to try and give you an idea how big this boat is. I just got the skins stretched on it. Again, this is 2.5 biminis. So the rear bimini, this one is 11 feet. And it comes to just past the swim step. Right? Just past the swim step. And 11 feet going forward puts it just in front of the helm. Right? So here's the helm. And we're just in front of the helm. That's 11 feet. And then we've got about a 5-foot gap. This is about 5 foot. That's why I needed a pole here in the middle to this one. And this is 10.5 feet. That's the size of this one. This one's 10'6". And that goes to about the front of the boat. We're standing right here at the bow. So we've got about a stern coverage with two massive bimini tops and a big 5-foot hole in the middle. So we're gonna get these two complete. I got all my lines to show me where I need to sew the pouches. We've got the outside leading edge, everything covered. We have labeled, this is the rear bimini forward, if that makes sense. So everything is clearly marked because I have two biminis. And then we'll just create an hourglass that zips in between them and zips onto that pole as well to give it some good support in the wind. But that's it for Saturday. Let's jump down and take a look at this boat. There we go. Can't see much there. We need to pin it up against the rack because the pump shop is booming. Again, that one's 11 feet. That one's 10.5. So they're nice sized biminis in it, and they still didn't cover this massive boat. Lots of fun. Thanks for following along. We'll make sure and include some more of the bimini fabrication for those that follow.